Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We are gathered here in the presence of God, both to witness and to bless the joining of these two people in Christian marriage. The covenant of marriage was established by God, who created us male and female for each other. With his presence and power, our Lord Jesus graced a wedding in Cana of Galilee. And in his sacrificial love, he gave us an example for the love of husband and wife. Jeff and Lisa come now to give themselves to one another in this holy covenant. I ask you now, in the presence of God and these people, to declare your intention to enter into union with one another through the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lisa, will you have Jeff to be your husband to live together in holy marriage?
I do.
Jeff, will you have Lisa to be your wife to live together in holy marriage?
I do.
Who presents Lisa to be united with Jeff in Christian marriage? The brother and I. Let's together some selected sentences from the Holy Scripture, which suggest to us both the nature of that sacrificial love which Jesus Christ expressed and gives to us as an example for the love of husband and wife, and that Holy Scripture as it addresses and lifts up the importance of Christian marriage. Hear this, the word of the Lord. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Let love be genuine and live in harmony. Hate what is evil, hold fast to what is good. Outdo one another in showing honor. Be humble and never conceit. Love is stronger than death, and jealousy cruel as the grave. Floods cannot drown love, and wealth cannot buy it. Put love above all else. Let Christ's peace rule your hearts. Always be forgiving as Christ has forgiven you. Love is not jealous or boastful, arrogant, rude, or stubborn, irritable, resentful, or possessive. Love is patient and kind. Do not love in word or speech only. Love also in deed and truth. Receive each other in sincerity. Find mercy and grow old together. Love rejoices in the right. It bears, believes, hopes, and endures all things. For love is faithful and endless. When the Lord builds the house, the labor is never in vain. As you come, Jeff, and as you come, Lisa, today, we lift you up before God in our prayers, asking God to bless you and thanking God that the two of you, by the grace of God, have been brought together. As we lift you up before God, we pray for God's strength and help, that your life together may indeed be a beautiful one. That as husband and wife, you will complement and support one another. You will make both beautiful
and complete the life of one another. We pray that you might, as the scripture says, indeed grow old together. Grow old in love. Grow old in such a way that even the years and the prospect of age become a beautiful and sweet memory to share together. Let us bow our heads as we pray. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, as friends and family, we do indeed lift up Jeff and Lisa in gratitude to you. We thank you for the families from which they come, for the nurture, the love they have received. And we thank you and rejoice that you have seen to bring them together, and that they come now with a desire, with your help, to continue in love, preferring, supporting, and loving one another with that kind of selfless love with which you have loved us in Jesus Christ our Lord. And now we do simply pray that you give them the strength and you give them the guidance, that their life together be full of your grace, full of love. In the name of Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. I need you to join hands at this point. So that's okay. You can turn and face one another, holiness. Jeff, you'll repeat after me. In the name of God.
I, Jeff.
Take you, Lisa.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold from this day. For better or for worse. For richer or for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death us do part. This is my solemn vow. In the name of God.
Hi, Lisa.
Take you, Jeff. To be my husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better or for worse. For richer or for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death us do part. This is my solemn vow. Wedding ring, please. These rings become an outward and visible symbol. May they be a reminder to you, Jeff, and you, Lisa, whenever you look upon them, of the vows that you have given and received this day in the presence of God. And I pray that as others look upon them, they'll rejoice and be supportive of your life together as husband and wife. Let us pray. Bless, O Lord God, both the giving and the receiving of these rings, that they who wear them may live in peace and continue in your favor all the days of their life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Put that on Lisa's ring finger and hold it there, repeating after me. And I'm going to let you look at her. And you can look at him. That's all right. Lisa,
I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor.
I honor.
And love you.
And love you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Yes, read the thing. Hold it, repeating after me.
Jeff?
Jeff?
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor.
I honor.
And love you.
And love you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
country club for the reception. Some of you who have come from out of town, if you need instructions as to how to go to the country club, I'm sure that Butch, your father, is driving back. And I would invite the ushers as the music resumes to come forward to escort fingers and hands in this music.
Thank you. I'm sorry.
So what do you know, Tom?
I'm Now I can't.